What's going on, Gorilla Grills Nation? How's everybody doing? I'm already laughing because Dominic's back there kind of cheesing around this afternoon. Welcome to Friday, everyone. I hope you guys have an awesome weekend upcoming. As always, just a couple more hours, guys, get through it. Almost there for the weekend. Today, guys, we're going to be doing kind of a kickoff to, not a burger series, but we've got a lot of burgers coming up here in the next couple of weeks. We just haven't done it in a while. We're coming into the spring, even though you can't really tell. Snow today, the ultimate Michigan April Fool's Day. I'm driving to work. I can barely see a hand in front of my face. Literally April, snow pouring down, Michigan weather. All good though, okay? So we're going to kick things off today with a braised short rib kind of blend, okay, in a burger, okay? Not braised, but actually smoked. I love short rib in my burger. I think it's really, really good. You can grind it from raw in there if you have a meat grinder at your house. More often than not, though, for the average home cook, including myself, I don't have a meat grinder. So we're going to get around that today. I'm going to show you how it's done. Let's get started with these short ribs, guys. All right, we just have some regular old long cut short ribs straight from the old butcher, okay? Easy to find. And I'm going to use today as a binder my secret ingredient. Little A1, all right?
We're not are you, like, going to get yelled at by all your chef friends for pulling out A1?
All my
A1
chef
right
friends
now?
Are like, dude, actually, we're all closet A1-aholics anyway. It's just how it works. We just don't admit it to anyone, except I'm admitting it to thousands of people right now. But that's all right. So a little bit of A1 on here, guys. Literally can't keep enough of this in my house. My wife literally has to stock me up at Costco. I'm not joking around. That's how much we go through. All right. We're going to use this as our binder, guys. Of course, Chef Drew style. We're going to get it all over the cutting board. No worries. All right, a little bit more A1.
These short ribs come from anywhere in particular, Byron Center Meats?
These came from Byron Center Meats, they sure did. Speaking of which, guys, love the fact you just asked that question. Kind of reminds me. Coming up in about a month's time, May 2nd and 3rd, all of you guys in the West Michigan area, I'm going to be at Byron Center Meats from 1 until 5 p.m. That's a Monday and a Tuesday. We're going to be out there with a couple of our grills, actually the Silverback and the Primate will be going out there. We're going to be cooking a whole bunch of different meats. Going to be teaching some classes. We're going to kind of be talking through some grilling techniques. Going to have some awesome index cards out there with some nice helpful hints on you that you can stick on your refrigerator. So come see me if you're in the area. Again, that's May 2nd and 3rd, Byron Center Meats, which is where these awesome short ribs came from. So stay tuned for that. And I'll keep reminding you guys in the weeks ahead. All right, guys. Just a little bit of our beef rub here. Okay, nice, generous amount. And I'm only going to do two sides here, all right? We're not going to quite coat this as much as we normally would when we're smoking, all right? Because we're going to be infusing a lot of flavor into these burgers. Remember, this is not our end game, all right? We just want to infuse a little bit of flavor here at the very beginning because we'll be spicing up that burger grind here in just a few minutes. All right.
Yeah, it's a really good tip because you can always take, you can always add more. You can't take enough.
Exactly. And again, if we were just smoking these and this is going to be the end product, we would coat all sides as we always do. But for this, just a little bit. Guys, 275, and like clockwork, okay? 275. Yesterday, when I was smoking off some short ribs for today, it was 275 for exactly 4 hours and 30 minutes for a perfect 202 degrees, okay? Like clockwork, you can do it longer if you want to, 225 for about 6 to 7 hours. If you're in a hurry or just want to get it over with, no worries, 275 for 4.5 hours, pull them, they'll be great to go. All right.
Like a pork butt, you're looking for that 205 degrees.
110%. All right, guys, next thing we're going to do, guys, is we're going to make our burger grind, and we'll start talking through a couple of things. All right. We got an 80-20 ground beef, 1 pound. And all that's saying is it's 80% lean, 20% fat. That's all that means. You can do 90-10, you can do 70-30. Kind of a nice industry standard, I think, is 80-20. It's what I use all the time at home.
Yeah, just, I notice if you go lower than 80-20, the burgers start to shrink up on you.
Shrink up on you. It just puts so much fat down in there, okay, when you're cooking. It just kind of dissolves on you because 30% fat is quite a lot. If you can get 90-10, that's a great ratio. But more often than not, you're probably going to find 80-20. That's about as much of a ratio as you want. 20% fat, still a decent amount, but we don't really want to go much more than that. All right, 1 pound of 80-20 ground chuck. Roughly a pound or so of our short ribs. Now what I did is I braised these short, smoked these short ribs yesterday. I put them in the refrigerator overnight, and then this morning when I got to work, and we'll look at these short ribs here in a second, the finished product before this, but put them in the refrigerator overnight, cut them into cubes or cut them off the bone, then cut them into little bite-sized pieces like this, and then I put this in our food processor. That's how we get this kind of texture, okay? as you can see, they're just kind of nice and ground up.
I thought that was like a barbecue rub at first.
Right? It's kind of weird. Now what we're going to do, and that's plenty, and what we're going to do, guys, about half and half, roughly a pound each. What we're going to do is we're going to see, oh yeah, these are going to do great. We just kind of get in there and mix, okay? Just going to make a nice kind of burger grind out of that, okay? Really, really good. Now, check this out. Just in case, if you're, you know, for whatever reason, if it's not quite binding all the way, these are, so we're in good shape. I have a couple eggs here on standby. You can totally use that if it's not quite coming together the way you want it. We don't need one in this case. Sometimes you will, but that's just kind of nature of the beast. A little bit more A1 sauce in here. All right. And believe it or not, a touch of mustard. There we go.
Just I was really hoping that would be stronger than
a little bit, about a tablespoon of mustard, okay? Be using that again in a second. A little bit more beef rub, just a little bit. Salt. This recipe, as always, guys, is up there for you. Okay. Just go to the beef section. You're going to see short rib burgers. Going to mix this in really nice. Check this out. Make sure we incorporate that mustard. And we're rocking and rolling. All right. Now, I'm going to show you guys a little trick. All right. Think we're done with this? Not so fast. All right. We're going to take the top of our deli container, all right? We're going to put a little bit of meat in there. Check this out. And we're going to use this to form our burger. So we're doing kind of a smash burger before the smash burger. All right, check that out.
Perfect for when you're using the griddle or when you just got to get a ton of burgers the same size.
100%, all right? There's one, okay? Just kind of form fit that. And we're going to do two of these, all right? So it's going to be one more. This is roughly about 4 ounces, guys. Just for kind of, if you want to get them super even at home, just so it's going to be half a cup, you can just kind of measure these out in half a cup increments. All right. Look at that. Perfect. Sweet. Form that back just a little bit there. And there we go. All right. Let's get these bad boys over here. Going to the Primate today. Everything we're going to be doing is on the griddle. All right. So let's get these started. There we are, a little bit of oil. We already have this bad boy fired up. There we go, boom, and boom. Next thing we're gonna do, guys, we're gonna make some home fries. Super easy, super fast. There we go. Got our cutting board changed over. Let's clear out some space here. Now, next thing we're gonna do, guys, nice and easy, nice and fun. We're gonna make some home fries, all right? What I've done is I've taken some Idaho, just normal russet potatoes, cut them in little rounds, about quarter inch rounds, and then I blanched them. Fancy way of saying is I'll boil them until they're about halfway done, took them out, stuck them in some ice water to cool them off, so these are about halfway cooked.
About how long does that take to get to that part?
Oh man, from the time, and I start it from the boil, so this goes in the cold water once it comes up. Essentially my metric is, start at cold water, potatoes in, once the water starts to boil, they're done.
Okay.
Pull them out. And then we'll just blanch them off, put them in an ice bath, and we want to make sure they're dry. As you can tell, these look pretty dry. I just put them on paper towels to dry them out, because when we put them on top of that Primate over there, it's going to get ripping hot. When it interacts with this bacon grease we're about to use, it's going to flare up on you. So we just kind of dried them off to prevent that. So, not wasting any time. Got a little bacon grease here. Bacon fat, I should say.
It's a perfect way to make American fries.
Dude. It's no more American than bacon and potatoes, does it?
Right.
That's definitely America. All right, here we go. Let's get them on. Nice and easy, guys. Let's see, they'll start to fry. That's all we'll need for this. And they cook nice and fast. Okay. Again, these are already halfway cooked. All right. Turn that up just a little bit. And the seasoning on this is super simple, guys. Super simple. Salt, pepper. All right, that's all we need. Salt, generous amount of salt, and pepper. Nothing fancy. That bacon's going to take it quite a long way. Remember, we want to use a generous amount of salt, but that bacon fat's already going to be pretty salty. So just kind of, you know, season accordingly. If you don't have any bacon fat lying around, no worries, just use canola oil. All good. All right, let's give these burgers a flip here. These are going to cook pretty quick. Look at that nice, beautiful caramelization, even on all the sides. As always, the Primate strikes again, and we're rocking and rolling. to blast the heat on these guys. And let's just have a look quickly over here while this stuff's kind of finishing off. Let's kind of go backtracking a little bit here. And let's look at these beautiful short ribs, okay, Magic ATV. That's what your short ribs are going to look like after they've been smoked for 4.5 hours, okay? They're going to be super, super tender, as you can see. Beautiful. Look how moist they are inside, literally. When these things start, okay, the meat fills out the bone all the way. As you can tell, we've shrunk in almost an inch on either side. Really, really great indicator, okay? Nice and moist in there, as we can see that coming out. Really great indicator is how far, excuse me, this meat comes off the bone, so that's good.
Yeah, that was one of the things that some barbecue guys have told me before, yeah. Is that in a barbecue competition, they judge your ribs partly by how far they pull away from
the bone. Totally.
If you get some pull away, that's always a good sign.
Yeah, totally. And not only that, you always want to tip it just to make sure, but you can really tell by how much of that bone is showing from start to finish when they're ready to pull it. If you do it enough times, that's kind of your metric. All right, let's get a couple things going here waiting for our burger. All right. Always like these big old tomatoes, okay? Serrated knife, I find cuts tomatoes the best. So let's go ahead and do one of these bad boys. All right, look at that duker. That's a freaking tomato, man.
Tomato hunk. Right. You're just gonna use that as the bun?
That's it, that's all you gotta do. Okay, a little bit of red onion. Use whatever onion you like. I like red onion for a burger, personally. We got that ready to rock and roll. Okay, that's gonna be awesome. Now, for lettuce, guys, I love using butter bib lettuce. Delicious. And when you buy it, what I really love about it, I'll be smarter than the plastic here, is it comes in living. Look at that. Check that out. Super cool. It's got the roots on it still. It's going to extract those really fast. All right. Pull that out.
Extract is a fancy way to say rip that off.
Right. And it comes out with these awesome, like, this is like burger ready right there. That's all you got to do. So we have what we call in the restaurant business, we have our setup. We're ready to rock and roll. Let's check this out over here.
All right, I got a question for you.
What's up?
Now, when you do burgers at home,
uh-huh,
are you putting condiments and onion, tomato, all that underneath the burger? Or are you putting it on top of the burger?
I'm a more on top of the burger type of dude, but tell you what I'm gonna do. I got a little system, okay? Got a system for everything. That's just how I like to roll. So we can see over here, guys, really quick, like, this goes super fast on this primate, okay? Okay, we got these nice lean patties that aren't too big, okay? We have these already blanched off. Look at that beautiful color on the outside, kind of rendering down with that bacon fat. Can't get rid of this. Spring is here, but the fall or the winter cold remains. We're gonna go ahead and use a little bit of white cheddar cheese, okay? The difference between white and yellow or orange cheddar cheese, you know what the difference is?
Nope.
Nothing. The color, the ingredients, the processing. They virtually taste exactly the same, okay? Not a huge difference. Typically the white's a little bit more refined. See that more of the fancy stuff. I like the white just because it looks cool, but we're gonna let that kind of melt down. We're gonna come over here, we're gonna grab a brioche bun, stick this on our flat top here for just a second, literally about 30 seconds. And what this does, guys, when we toast this bun, it creates a barrier, okay? A really nice barrier between the meat and everything that's gonna be going on here. So of course that meat's gonna come out just a little bit. It's always gonna have its natural juices. When this thing gets toasted, I told you it doesn't take long, it just creates a little bit of a barrier, kind of protects that bread a little bit, all right? So, on to my method. This guy's ready to go. Let's go ahead and assemble our burger while our potatoes kind of finish off. All right, what I like to do, guys, and this is how I eat my burger, you guys do it however you like, okay? I like a little bit of Dijon mustard on the very bottom, okay? Just enough to coat it. I don't do mayonnaise, I don't do mustard, or excuse me, I don't do ketchup. I just like a little bit of mustard on the bottom, okay? Done. I like Dijon for this anyway. Gonna put our burger on there. Look how delicious that looks. And then what I'm gonna do, take our lettuce, tomato, onion, call it a setup. I'm gonna set you up, Dominic, okay? Nice big hunk in there. We're gonna turn it right over. And this is what we're gonna do, guys. We're gonna put it on this plate. All right, I'm gonna stick a knife right in the middle of it, all the way down to the bottom, and there we go. Last but not least, let's go ahead and get some of our potatoes on here. Really, really nice potatoes. Beautiful color, kind of home fries, rocking and rolling. get a couple more. We don't like hungry people around here at Grilla Grills. And there we are. Guys,
I can smell the bacon on those.
Dude, isn't that good?
It's awesome.
And guys, we're not being fancy here. We have a burger, okay? A really nice big burger. That's a half a pound total, 4 ounce patties. We have our awesome home fries cooked in bacon fat, salt, pepper, that's it. Mustard on the bottom, toasted brioche bun, big old hunk of red onion, big old duker of a tomato, nice setup over there with that bib lettuce on the top. And that's it, guys. Play around with it, have some fun, let me know. Now, when you go into your recipe, one quick thing. All right, you're gonna look up the recipe. It's gonna call. It's gonna be your short rib burger. Okay. When you look that up, if you look at the short ribs, okay, in parentheses, it's going to see recipe at GrillaGrills.com. So you're gonna have to go in and find smoked short ribs, follow that recipe for your short ribs, and then excuse me, press on with the burger grun as soon as that's done. All right. Outside of that, guys, as always, we love you on the smoke. Like, share, subscribe. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you guys next week. I look forward to seeing all of you in about a month at Byron Center Meats here in West Michigan. That's May 2nd and 3rd. Cheers, everybody. See you soon.